Good morning. Let me take this opportunity to welcome everyone to our 2017 Mobile County 90th Annual Spelling Bee. I am Reginald Eggleston. I'm one of the assistant superintendents for the school system. And on behalf of Ms. Martha Peake, our superintendent, let me welcome everyone, welcome all of our participants, and say congratulations to you. Let's give them a round of applause at this time. We're very proud of you and congratulate you on your success. And we know that you're going to do a very good job today. Let me also congratulate all of our schools, our teachers, administrators, and parents who have contributed to the young people's success. It takes everyone working together in order for this type of event to occur, so let me say thank you to you as well for your contributions. And also we want to say thank you to Dollar General, for partnering with the Mobile County Public School System in hosting this event today. It takes everyone in the community partnering and working together in order to create the right types of experiences for our young people. I know we're in for a treat today, so again, let me say welcome, and again, congratulations to all of our students and everyone who has contributed to their success. Thank you.
Hello, good morning. I'm Amber Smalley. I am temporarily the person in charge of elementary reading for Mobile County. I'm so glad that y'all are here today. I'm so glad that you guys are here today. Y'all need to smile. Can y'all do that? About half of them smiled. Maybe they'll get with it. We have some wonderful judges here today. We have Miss Christy Logan. There she is, she's wonderful. We have Marilyn Austin. We have Mr. John Parker. Miss Molly Nordman. And Mr. James Miles. Let me tell you, we have a wonderful word announcer. He does a lot for Mobile County Public Schools. We have Mr. Bob Gritt. Come on up, Mr. Bob.
Good morning, everybody. Good morning, students.
Good morning.
You're already good spellers. I know that because you're sitting up here on the stage. Excellent. You ready, number one? Go right ahead. Come forward to the microphone. Use whichever one you want to use. And remember to say the word, spell the word, say the word again. You can ask for word derivation. You can ask me to use the word in a sentence and see if I know it. Actually, I've got a list. All right. You ready to go? What's your name?
DeKalu.
Perfect. Got that one right already. Your word is shampoo.
Shampoo. S-H-A-M-P-O-O, shampoo.
Correct. Very good. Your word is garage.
Garage. G-A-R-A-G-E, garage.
Correct. Your word is balcony.
Balcony. B-A-L-C-O-N-Y. Balcony.
Right. Okay, our next word has a homonym, so I'm going to give you the definition because it could be confusing. The word is tutu. It's from a French word. It's a very short projecting skirt worn by a ballet dancer. Tutu.
T-U-T-U.
Correct. Be sure to say the word, spell the word, then say it again. Your word is icicle.
Icicle. I-C-E-S-I-C-L-E. Icicle.
Sorry. Your word is mosque.
Mosque. M-O-S-Q-U-E. Mosque.
Correct. Your word is futon.
Futon. F-U-T-A. Futon.
Sorry. Your word is humble.
Humble. H-U-M-B-L-E. Humble.
Yes. Your word is rucksack.
R-O-C-K-S-A-C-K.
Sorry. Your word is interrupt.
Interrupt. I-N-T-E-R-R-U-P-T. Interrupt.
Right. All right. And a reminder to all the contestants, too, you can start to spell the word again, but you just can't change letters when you go back the second time. Not that anybody's needed it, but just in case. Your word is Android.
Android. A-N-D-R-O-I-D. Android.
Right. Your word is rehearse.
Rehearse. R-E-H-E-A-R-S-E. Rehearse.
Yes. Your word is foyer.
Foyer. F-O-Y-E-R. Foyer.
Correct. Our next word is saxophone.
Saxophone. S-A-X-O-P-H-O-N-E. Saxophone.
Correct. Your word is apricot.
Apricot. A-P-R-I-C-O-T. Apricot.
That's right. Your word is adobe.
Adobe. A-D-O-B-E. Adobe.
Correct. Okay, your word also has a homonym, so I'll give you the definition. It's baton, it's from the French, and it's a club used as a weapon, especially a police officer's billy club, a baton.
Baton. B-A-T-O-N, baton.
Correct. Your word is Dracula.
Can you say it again, please?
Dracula.
D-R-A-C-U-L-U-M. Dracula.
Sorry. Your word is yacht.
Yacht. Y. A-C-H-T, yacht.
Very good. Your word is safari.
Safari. S-A-F-A-R-I, safari.
Very good. Your word is nightingale.
Can you tell me the definition, please?
Sure. A nightingale is a thrush common in Great Britain that is noted for the sweet song of the male, often heard at night during the breeding season. Nightingale.
Nightingale.
N-I-G-H-T.
T-I-G-A-L-E, Nightingale.
Sorry. This word could be confused with another word, so I'll say the word and I'll give you the part of speech and the definition. Guitar. It's from a word that went from Greek to Arabic to Spanish to French, and it's a flat-bodied stringed instrument with a long fretted neck and usually six strings played with a pick or plucked with the fingers. Guitar.
Guitar. G-U-I-T-A-R. Guitar.
Right. Your word is Bruin.
Can you repeat the word?
Bruin.
Bruin. B-R-U-I-N. Bruin.
Correct. Your word is jute.
Jute. May I get the definition?
Sure. The glossy fiber of either two East Indian plants used chiefly for sacking, burlap, and the cheaper varieties of twine.
May I get the language of origin?
You may. It's from Sanskrit.
Can you repeat the word?
Mm-hmm. Jute.
J-I-U-T,
jute? Sorry. Your word is pretzel.
Pretzel. P-R-E-T-Z-E-L. Pretzel.
That's right. Your word is finale.
Can you repeat the word?
Finale.
Finale. F-I-N-N-A-L-Y. Finale.
Sorry. Our next word, chutney.
Can you use the word in a sentence, please?
Sure. Spicy or sweet chutney is sometimes eaten with Indian meals containing curry.
Can you tell me the origin?
It is from a word that went from Prakrit to Hindi.
Chutney, C-H-O-T-N-E-Y, chutney.
Sorry. Your word is stucco.
Can you repeat the word?
Stucco.
Stucco. S-T-U-C-C-O. Stucco.
Correct. Your word is geode.
Definition, please.
Sure. It's a nodule of stone having a cavity lined with crystals or mineral matter.
G-E-O-D. G-O.
Sorry. Your word is sushi.
Sushi. S-U-S-H-I, sushi.
Correct. Your word is Pueblo.
Pueblo. P-U-E-B-L-O, Pueblo.
Correct. Next word is mentor.
Mentor. M-E-N-T-O-R.
Right. Your word is jovial.
Jovial. J-O-V-E-L. Jovial.
Sorry. Your word is fidelity.
Can I hear the definition?
Sure. The quality or state of being faithful or loyal as to a person, cause, party, or nation.
Fidelity. P H A D E L I T Y. Fidelity.
Sorry. Your word is diorama.
Can you repeat it?
Diorama.
Diorama. D I A O R A M A.
Sorry. Your word is Kona. Now this is a homonym, so I'm going to say the word Kona. It's from a Hawaiian word, and it's a storm of southerly or southwesterly winds and heavy rains in Hawaii.
Repeat the word.
Kona.
K-O-N-A.
That's right. All right, this next word has a homonym, so I'm going to say the word and then give you the part of speech. The word is Spitz, and it comes from the German word. It's a medium-sized white dog descended from Pomeranian ancestors and often regarded as constituting a separate breed, Spitz.
S-P-I-T-S, Spitz.
Sorry. Your word is hibachi.
Hibachi. H-A-B-C-H-I. Hibachi.
Sorry. Your word is grotto.
Grotto. G-R-O-T-O. Grotto.
Sorry. Your word is coyote.
Coyote. C-O-Y-O-T-E.
Coyote. Yes.
Your word is homonym.
Homonym. May I please have the definition?
You may. One of two or more words pronounced alike, but different in meaning or derivation or spelling.
Homonym. Homonym. H-O-M-O-N-Y-M.
That's right. Reminder to everybody, say the word, spell the word, and then say the word again so we know that you're finished. Your word is dungaree.
Dungaree. D-U-N-G-A-R-E-E, dungaree.
Correct. Your word is collage.
Collage. C-O-L-L-A-G-E, collage.
Yes. Okay, this word has a homonym, so I'll give you the derivation and the definition. The word I need is mumu, and this word is from a Hawaiian word. It's a loose dress worn chiefly in Hawaii, having bright colors and patterns, and adapted from the dresses originally distributed by missionaries to the native women. Mumu.
Mumu. M-O-O-M-O-O. Mumu.
Sorry. Your word is dugong.
May I please give me the definition?
An aquatic herbivorous mammal that has a two-lobed tail, and in the male, upper incisors altered into short tusks, is related to the manatee, and that commonly attains a length of 8 feet or more.
What's the word again?
Dugong.
Dugong? D-U-G-O-N, Dugong?
Sorry. Your word is animosity.
Animosity. A-N-I-M-O-S-I-T-Y.
Correct. Your word is trauma.
Trauma. T-R-A-U-M-A. Trauma.
Correct. Your word is embargo.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Say it again?
Can you use it in a sentence?
I sure can. In defiance of the embargo, the captain eased his ship out of the harbor at night.
Embargo. E-M-B-A-R-G-O.
Yes. Speak up. Be bold. Your word is dogma.
Could you say the word again, please?
Dogma.
Dogma. D-O-G-M-A. Dogma.
Correct. Your word is expertise.
Expertise. E-X-P-E-R-T-I-S-E. Expertise.
Right. Your word is nosh.
Nosh. Could you please say the definition?
Mm-hmm. Eat a snack.
Could you please use the word in the sentence?
Mm-hmm. Becky and her sister usually nosh on fruit after school.
Nosh. N-O-S-H. Nosh.
Correct. Your word is dross.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. The critic commented that although there is certainly no shortage of dross on television, the medium is in the midst of a creative renaissance.
Dross. D-R-O-S-E. Dross.
Sorry. Your word is fandango.
Fandango. F-A-N-D-A-N-G-O. Fandango.
That's right. Your word is cabana.
Cabana. Can you use the word in a sentence?
I sure can. Sam and Doug will move the cabana closer to the swimming pool.
Cabana. Cabana. C-A-B. A-N-O, cabana.
Sorry.
C-A-N.
And your word is gondola.
Gondola. G-O-N-D-O-L-A, gondola.
Correct. And that's the end of the first round. Congratulations, everybody. They did a great job with great words. We still have quite a few students left, so that's wonderful. Good to have you back. Your word is cognition.
Can I get a definition?
Sure. The intellectual process by which knowledge is gained about perceptions or ideas.
Can I get a sentence?
Mm-hmm. New drugs are being developed to improve cognition in schizophrenic patients.
Cognition. C-O-G-N-I-T-I-O-N.
Yes. Your word is matinee.
Matinee?
Uh-huh.
M-A-T-T-I-N-A.
Sorry. The word is alligator.
Alligator. A-L-L-I-G-A-T-O-R. Alligator.
That's correct. That's correct. And if you do have a cell phone, if you could silence it, please. We don't want to distract anybody up here. Thank you. Your word is kahuna.
Can you repeat that?
Kahuna.
K-A-H-O-O-N-A.
Sorry. Your word is alfalfa.
Alfalfa. A-L-F-A-O-F-A. Alfalfa.
That's right. Your word is clementine.
Clementine. C-L-E-M-E-N-T-I-N-E. Clementine.
Very good. Your word is feldspar.
Feldspar. Could I please have the language of origin?
The word of origin, the word is from the German, plus a German-derived English word.
Can I please have it in a sentence?
Sure. Feldspar is present in most igneous rocks.
Feldspar. F-E-L-D-S-P-A-R. Feldspar.
Yes. Your word is hominy.
Can you please repeat?
Hominy.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. For breakfast, the hotel offered griddle cakes, hominy, and scrambled eggs.
Hominy. H-O-M-O-N-E-Y. Hominy.
Sorry. Your word is layette.
Can I have the definition?
Mm-hmm. A complete outfit of clothing and equipment for a newborn infant.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Yes. Mrs. Rudolph's gift for the baby shower is a beautiful handmade layette she bought while in the Philippines.
Can I have the language of origin?
Word is from the French.
Layette. L. A. Y-E-T-T-E, layette.
Correct. Your word is imperative.
Can I have the definition?
Mm-hmm. Not to be avoided or evaded, urgent, compulsory.
Imperative. I-M-P-A-R-A-T-I-V-E. Imperative.
Sorry. Your word is vibrato.
Can you repeat the word?
Vibrato.
What is the language of origin?
Word came from the Italian, which formed it from a Latin word.
Can I get the, can I use it in a sentence?
Sure. The music teacher commented that some vocalists use vibrato to hide the fact they can't sing in tune.
Vibrato. V-E-B-R-A-T-T-O. Vibrato.
Sorry. Your word is benefactor.
Benefactor. B-E-N-E-F-A-C-T-O-R. Benefactor.
Right. All right. Your word has a homonym, so I'm going to say the word pompous and then provide the word. It's a plural noun, and it means an extensive, generally grass-covered plain of temperate South America east of the Andes, the prairies. Pampas.
Pampas. P-A-M-P-A-S. Pampas.
Yes. Your word is wiseacre.
Wiseacre. W-I-S-E-A-C-R-E, wiseacre.
Right. This word is a homonym too. It's clabbered. It's the first part of this word is from Dutch, second part is from English. It's a noun. It's a narrow board that is usually thicker at one edge than the other and is used for weatherboarding outside walls. Clabbered.
Clabbered. C-L-A-P-B-O-A-R-D. Clabbered.
Yes. Your word is contiguous.
Contiguous. C-O-N-T-I-G-U-O-U-S. Contiguous.
Right. Very good. Your word is pinafore.
Pinafore. Can I have the word of origin?
Word consists of two originally English elements.
What's the definition?
It's a sleeveless, low-necked, wraparound garment tied or buttoned at the back and worn to protect clothes from soil.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Mm-hmm. Mrs. Dobbins wears a canvas pinafore while working in the potting shed.
Pinafore. P-E-N-I-P-H-O-R-E, pinafore?
Sorry. This word could be confused with another word, so I'll say the word and give you the part of speech in that. Iguana. It's a word from, went from Arawak to Spanish. It's a noun. Any of a number of large, herbivorous, chiefly tropical American lizards, being typically dark-colored with a serrated dorsal crest and attaining a length of several feet. Iguana.
Iguana. I-G-U-A-N-A. Iguana.
Yes. Your word is discern.
Discern. D-I-S-C-E-R-N. Discern.
Right. Your word is Fletcherism.
Can you repeat the word?
Fletcherism.
Fletcherism. F-L-E-T-C-H-E-R-I-S-M.
Yes. Your word is incorruptible.
Incorruptible. I-N-C-O-R-R-U-P-T-I-B-L-E.
Yes. Your word is daffodil.
Daffodil. D-A-F-F-O-D-I-L. Daffodil.
Yes. Your word is toucan.
Toucan. T-O-U-C-A-N.
Right. Your word is adjacent.
Give me a definition.
Mm-hmm. Having a common border.
A, G, A, C, E, N, T.
Sorry. All right, this word has a homonym, so I'll go into the detail. It's hawthorn. It's originally from the English, it's a noun. It's a spring flowering shrub or tree, usually having thorny branches, white or pink fragrant flowers, and small red fruits.
Can you repeat the word?
Hawthorn.
Can you repeat it one more time?
Hawthorn.
Hawthorn?
Hawthorn.
H A U-T-H-O-R-N.
Sorry. Your word is Crusoe.
Crusoe. May you please repeat the word?
Crusoe.
Crusoe. What type of language?
Okay, it's from an English literary name.
Can I get the definition?
Mm-hmm. A solitary castaway, one who lives or survives by his or her own unaided effort and ingenuity.
Crusoe. C R E W S O.
Sorry. Okay, this word could be confused with another word, so I'll give you the rundown. It's isobar. It's a word from a word that went from Greek to international scientific vocabulary. It's a noun. It's a line on a map marking places on the surface of the Earth where the height of the barometer reduced to sea level is the same either at a given time or for a certain period. Isobar.
Isobar. I-S-O-B-A-R. Isobar.
Correct. Your word is mirage.
Can you please repeat the word?
Mirage.
Can one more time, please?
Mirage.
Barrage?
No, mirage.
Mirage. M-I-R-A-G-E, mirage.
Yes. Your word is catkin.
Catkin. C-A-T-K-I-N, catkin.
Yes. Your word is boutique.
Boutique. B-O-U-T-I-Q-U-E.
That's right. This word could be confused with another word. It's jackal. It's from Sanskrit that went to Persian and then to Turkish. It's a noun. It's any of several small wild dogs in the Old World, less daring than wolves, sometimes hunting in packs, but more usually singly or in pairs, and feeding on carrion and small animals. Jackal.
Jackal. J-A-C-K-A-L. Jackal.
Yes. Your word is caribou.
Caribou. C-A-R-I-B-U. Caribou.
Sorry. Your word is quell.
Quell. Q-U-E-L-L. Quell.
Yes. Your word is pumpernickel.
Pumpernickel. Could you please say the definition?
Mm-hmm. A sourdough bread made with rye and wheat flours.
Could you use the word in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. Sam's favorite sandwich is ham and Swiss on pumpernickel.
Pumpernickel. P-U-M-P-E-R-N-I-C-K-E-L. Pumpernickel.
Correct. Your word is potash.
Could you repeat it?
Potash.
Potash.
No, potash.
Oh, potash. P-O-T-A-C-H. Potash.
Sorry. Your word is shogun.
Shogun. May I have the language of origin, please?
It is from a Chinese-derived Japanese word.
Shogun. S-H-O-G-U-N.
Correct. That's the end of the second round. All right. We're going to take a short break, give everybody a chance to breathe deeply and stretch a little bit. So we'll be right back.
I believe that the quality of education that I received at the Mobile County Public School System, I would give it an A+, excellent education. And I feel that they prepared me for my future career. I feel that I received not only the fund of knowledge that I need, but the social skills, communication skills that is needed to compete with any other student, not just in Mobile County particularly, but nationwide.
This word could be confused with another word, so I'll tell you the word and give you the definition. It's Autobahn. It's a noun. The word is from a Greek-derived German word plus a German word. It's a German, Swiss, or Austrian expressway. Autobahn.
Can you repeat that word?
Autobahn.
Can you repeat it again?
Autobahn.
O, Autobahn, I think. O, D, O, B, O, N, D.
Sorry. Our next word could be confused with a similar word, so I'll give you the derivation and all that. The word is innate. It's from the Latin. It's an adjective. It means existing in or belonging to some person or other living organism from birth. Innate.
Innate. I-N-A-T-E. Innate.
Sorry. This word could be confused with another word, so I'll go through the round. It's mutable. This word consists of an English part and an English combining form. It's an adjective. It means open to debate or debatable.
Mutable. M-O-O-T-A-B-L-E. Mutable.
Right. Your word is Gestapo.
Gestapo. G-E-S-T-A-P-O. Gestapo.
That's right. Your word has a homonym. It's quiche. It's originally from the German. The word became French before entering English. It's a noun. It's a baked custard pie, usually having an added savory ingredient such as chopped ham, seafood, or vegetables. They're yummy. I just added that last part. Quiche.
Quiche. Q-U-I-C-H-E. Quiche.
Yes. Your word is haiku.
Haiku. Can I have the definition?
You may. It is an unrhymed verse of Japanese origin, having three lines containing usually five, seven, and five syllables, respectively, referring in some way to one of the seasons of the year.
Haiku. H-A-I-K-U. Haiku.
That's right. Not to be confused with Haiku, which is sponsored by New Horizons Credit Union, which is an academic program that I also do. It sounds similar. That was a plug. Okay, here's a word that could be confused with another word, so I'll go through what I can. It's lariat. The word is from a word that went from Latin to Spanish. It's a noun. It's a long, light, but strong rope used with a running noose for catching livestock. Lariat.
Lariat. L-A-R-I-E-T-T-E. Lariat.
Sorry. Your word is croquet.
Can I have the definition?
Mm-hmm. It's a game in which players drive wooden balls with mallets through a series of wickets set out on a lawn in a particular order.
What's the language of origin?
It is from French.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. Erica and her friends played croquet in the churchyard.
C-R-O. K-A-I?
Sorry. Your word is mantilla.
Could you repeat the word?
Mantilla.
Could you please give me a definition?
Mm-hmm. It's a light scarf, often of black lace, worn over the head and shoulders, especially by Spanish and Latin American women.
Mantilla. M-A-N-T-I-O-T. Mantilla.
Sorry. Your word is odori.
Could you repeat the word?
Odori.
Odori. O-D-O-R-I. Odori.
Yes. This word could be confused with another word. It's langosta. It's a word that went from Latin to Spanish. It's a noun. It's a South or Central American spiny lobster.
Langosta. L-A-N-G-A-S-T-A. Langosta.
Sorry. Your word is plausible.
plausible. P-L-A-U-S-I-B-L-E. Plausible.
Correct. Your word is Boswell.
Boswell. B-O-S-W-E-L-L.
Yes. Say the word, spell the word, say the word again. Your word is Maddock.
Can you repeat the word?
Maddock.
Malik?
Maddock.
Can you repeat the word?
Maddock.
Maddock?
Maddock.
Can you repeat the word?
Maddock.
Can you repeat the word?
Sure. Maddock.
With the origin?
Sure. The word is from a word that went from Latin to English.
Maddock?
Maddock.
Maddock. M A D D O C.
Sorry. Your word is vigilante.
Vigilante. V I G I L A N T E. Vigilante.
Yes. Our next word is extravaganza.
Extravaganza. E-X-T-R-A-V-A-N. G-A-N-Z-A.
Sorry. Your word is Samaritan.
Samaritan. S-U-M-E-R-I-T-A-N.
Sorry. Your word is filibuster.
Filibuster. F-I-L-I-B-U-S-T-E-R. Filibuster.
That's correct. Your word is synopsis.
Synopsis. S-Y-N-O-P-S-I-S. Synopsis.
Yes. Your word is Illuminati.
Illuminati?
Mm-hmm.
Illuminati. I L L U M. I-N-A-U-T-Y.
Sorry. Your word is asterisk.
Asterisk. A-S-T-E-R-I-S-K.
Yes. Our next word is purga.
Can you use it in a sentence?
I sure can. It's an intense Arctic snowstorm, usually occurring in flat, open country, and characterized by severe cold and wind-driven snow.
Can you say it again?
Sure. Purga.
Purga. P-E-R-G-A. Purga.
Sorry. Your word is teriyaki.
Teriyaki. T-E-R-I-Y-A-K-I. Teriyaki.
Yes. This word has a homonym. It's from the German. It's diesel. It's a noun. It's a vehicle, as a truck, a locomotive, or a ship, driven by an internal combustion engine in which air is compressed to a temperature sufficiently high to ignite fuel injected directly into the cylinder, where the combustion and expansion actuate a piston. Diesel.
Diesel. D-I-E. S-E-L, diesel.
Correct. Your word is percolate.
Percolate. May I have the language of origin?
You may. It's from the Latin.
May I have the definition?
You may. It's to undergo a method of extraction by means of filtration.
Percolate. P-E-R-C-O-L-A-T-E, percolate.
Right. It's the end of the third round. They've done very, very well. We've gone through about 115, 116 words so far. All right, we're ready to begin the next round, judges? All right. This next word could be confused with another word, so I'll run through the gamut. The word is regatta. It's from the Italian. It's a noun. It's an organized series of rowing, speedboat, or sailing races. Regatta.
Regatta. R-E-G-A-T-T-A. Regatta.
Yes. The word is intractable.
Intractable. I-N-T-R-A-C-T-A-B-L-E. Intractable.
Yes. Your word is clompen.
Can I please have the language of origin?
It's from the Dutch.
Clompen. C L O M P N, clompen?
Sorry. Your word is omnipotent.
Omnipotent. O M N I P O T E N T, omnipotent.
Correct. Your word is juggernaut.
Juggernaut.
Could you give the language of origin?
Sure. It's a word that went from Sanskrit to Hindi.
Juggernaut. J A U T E R N A U T. Juggernaut.
Sorry. This could be confused with another word. It's ingenious. Came from the French, which formed it from a Latin word. It's an adjective. And it's marked by originality, resourcefulness, and cleverness in conception or execution.
Ingenious. I-N-G-E-N-I-O-U-S. Ingenious.
Ingenious, yes, that's right. Very good. Your word is bravura.
Bravura. B-R-A-V-U-R-A. Bravura.
Right. The word is impasse.
Impasse. Can you give me the language of origin?
The word is from the French.
Impasse. E-M-P-A-S-S, impasse.
Sorry. This word could be confused with another word, so I'll spell out everything for you except for spelling. It's hygiene. It's from the Greek. It's a noun. Conditions or practices conducive to health.
Hygiene. H-Y-G-I-E-N-E. Hygiene.
Yes. Our next word is mercurial.
Mercurial?
Mercurial.
Mercurial. M-E-R-C-U-R-I-A-L. Mercurial.
Right. This word has a homonym. It's foliate. It's from the Latin. It's an adjective. Means shaped like a leaf.
Can you say it again?
Foliate.
Foliate. F-O-L-I-A-T-E.
Yes. This word could be confused with another word. It's boysenberry. It's from an American name plus an originally English word. It's a noun. It's a very large bramble fruit with a flavor like a raspberry, especially valued for canning and preserving. Boysenberry.
Boysenberry. B-O-Y-S-E-N-B-E-R-R-Y. Boysenberry.
Correct. Your word is colloquial.
Colloquial. Could you please say the definition?
It is of or relating to conversation.
May I use the word in a sentence?
Eva's colloquial style lent an air of comfortable informality to her composition.
Colloquial. C-O-L-L-O-Q-U-I-A-L. Colloquial.
Correct. Your word is babushka.
Babushka. B-A-B-U-S-H-K-A. Babushka.
Correct. That's the end of the fourth round. I don't know about you, but I like when I say the word and I can see the gleam go off in their eyes, like, yes, I've seen that word before, and yes, I can spell it. You too. All right, take a deep breath. All right, we're ready. Your word is schnauzer.
Schnauzer. S-C-H-N. A-U-Z-E-R, schnauzer.
Right. Your word is macadamia.
Macadamia, M-A-C-A-D-A-M-I-A, macadamia.
That's right. Your word is nebbish.
Nebbish. Can I have the definition?
Mm-hmm. It's a timid, meek, or ineffectual person.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. The father in sitcoms is sometimes portrayed as a bumbling nebbish.
Nebbish. N-E-B-B-I-S-H. Nebbish.
Very good. Your word is sayonara.
Can you repeat the word?
Sayonara.
Sayonara. S-I-O-N-A-R-A. Sayonara.
Sorry. Your word is pochismo.
Can you please repeat the word?
Pochismo.
P-O-C-H-E-E-Z-M-O-E.
Sorry. Your word is streusel.
Streusel. S-T-R-E-U-S-A-L.
Sorry. Your word is cacao.
Cacao. C-A-C-A-O, cacao.
Right. Your word is Mahatma.
Mahatma. M-A-H-A-T-M-A. Mahatma.
Very good. This next word could be confused with another word. It's keel haul. It came from a Dutch word with two English words, one of which is Dutch and the other of which is Germanic-derived French. It's a verb. It means to rebuke with great severity. Keel haul.
Keel haul. K-E-E-L-H-A-U-L. Keel haul.
Right. Your word is umlaut.
Umlaut. May I please have the definition?
It's a diacritical mark composed of two adjacent dots placed especially over a German vowel to indicate a change of a vowel caused by partial assimilation to a succeeding sound.
Umlaut. U-M-L-A-U-T. Umlaut.
That's right. Your word is piccolo.
Piccolo. P-I-C-C-O-L-O. Piccolo.
Right. End of round five. All right, ready to start round six. The word is cavia.
Cavia. K-A-V-Y-A. Cavia.
Very good. This word is a near homonym. It's junta. It's from a word that went from Latin to Spanish. It's a noun. It's a closely knit group of persons composing or dominating a government, especially after a revolutionary seizure of power. Junta.
Junta. H-U-N-T-A. Junta.
Sorry. Okay, this word has a near homonym. Kitsch. It's from the original German. It's a noun. It means artistic or literary material held to be of low quality, often produced to appeal to popular taste and marked especially by sentimentalism, sensationalism, and slickness. Kitsch.
Kitsch. K-I-T-S-C-H. Kitsch.
That's right. Your word is hacienda.
Hacienda. H-A-C-I-E-N-D-A. Hacienda.
Very good. Your word is sevruga.
Sevruga. Mm-hmm. S-E-V-R-U-G-A. Sevruga.
That's right. Your word is duenna.
Duenna.
May I have a definition, please?
Mm-hmm. An elderly woman serving as a governess and companion to the younger ladies in a Spanish or a Portuguese family.
Duenna. D-U-E-N-N-A. Duenna.
Right. The word is Malahini.
Malahini. May I please give me the definition?
It's a newcomer or stranger among the people of Hawaii.
Malahini. M-A-L-I-H-I-N-I. Malahini.
Right. This word has a near homonym. Wanton. It's originally from the English. It's an adjective. Marked by or manifesting heedless disregard of justice or the rights, safety, and feelings of others. Wanton.
Wanton. W-A-N-T-O-N. Wanton.
That's correct. End of round six. The line gets shorter and shorter. Your word, amphibious.
Amphibious. A-M-P-H-I-B-I-O-U-S. Amphibious.
Very good. The word is ergonomic.
Ergonomic. May I have the definition?
You may. Of or relating to an applied science. Concerned with designing and arranging things so that people and those things will interact most effectively and safely.
May I have the part of speech?
It is an adjective.
Ergonomic?
Yes.
E-R-G-O-N-O-M-I-C. Ergonomic.
Very good. This next word could be confused with another word, so I'll run through everything. Oregano. It's originally a word that went from Greek to Latin to Spanish. It's a noun, and it's any of various aromatic herbs that are used as seasonings in cookery.
Oregano. O-R-E-G-A-N-O. Oregano.
Right. Your word is tarragon.
Tarragon. T-E-R-R-A-G-O-N. Tarragon.
Sorry. The word is fastidious.
Fastidious. May I have a definition, please?
You may. Marked by a meticulous, sensitive, or demanding attitude.
Fastidious. F-A-S. T-I-D-I-O-U-S. Fastidious.
Right. Your word is accommodate.
Accommodate. May you please have the definition?
Mm-hmm. Provide with lodgings.
May I use the word in a sentence?
Arthur insisted on staying in a hotel that would accommodate Paco, his elderly chihuahua.
Accommodate. A-C-C-O-M-M-O-D-A-T-E. Accommodate.
Right. Your word is Meistersinger.
Would you repeat the word, please?
Meistersinger.
May I have the language of origin?
You may. It's originally from German.
Would you use it in a sentence, please?
Mm-hmm. Mr. Heinz can trace his family tree back to a Bavarian Meistersinger born in 1498.
Meistersinger. M-E-I-S-T-E-R-S-I-N-G-E-R. Meistersinger.
Correct. End of round seven.
Do you have what it takes to be an Envision graduate? We are pioneering students to be all they can be, from sixth grade all the way to 12th grade,
I definitely would recommend Envision to other students who feel the way I feel. They really work with you and they've gotten tutors and you have online teachers to talk to.
It starts right here. It starts right now. Envision Virtual Academy. Enroll today.
We've finished round 7. Let's start round 8. Good luck, everybody. Your word is mystique.
Mystique. Can I have the origin?
Sure. The word is from an originally Greek word that passed into Latin and then to French.
Can I use it in a sentence?
I can. Climbing the 7 summits, which are composed of the highest mountain on each of the 7 continents, has a great mystique for alpinists.
M-Y-S-T-I-Q-U-E, mystique.
That's right. The word is precipitate.
Precipitate. Can I have the definition?
Mm-hmm. It's to separate from a solution as a substance in a concrete state as a result of a chemical or physical change.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Sediment forms in hot water tanks when minerals precipitate and settle on the bottom.
Precipitate. P R E C I P I T A T E. Precipitate.
Yes. Your word is staccato.
Staccato. S-T-A-C-C-A-T-O, staccato.
Very good. The word is wainscot.
Wainscot. May I have a definition, please?
Mm-hmm. The lower 3 or 4 feet of an interior wall when finished differently from the remainder of the wall, as with wood panels, tile, or marble slabs.
Wainscot. W-A-I-N-S-C-O-T, wainscot.
Very good. Your word is samurai.
Samurai. May you please say the definition?
Mm-hmm. A military retainer of a Japanese feudal lord, practicing the chivalric code of Bushido, privileged to wear 2 swords and having the power of life and death over the commoners.
Samurai. S-A-M-U-R-A-I, samurai.
That's right. Your word is chagrin.
Chagrin. C-H-A-G-R-I-N, chagrin.
Very good. End of round 8. All right, we're going to continue. The word is hippopotamus.
Hippopotamus. H-I-P-P-O-P-T-A-M-U-S. Hippopotamus.
Sorry. The word is capitulation.
Capitulation. Can I have the definition?
You may. The act or agreement of one that surrenders to an enemy upon stipulated terms.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. The capitulation took place on the battlefield at noon.
Capitulation. C A P I T U L A T I O N. Capitulation.
That's right. Your word is sortie.
Sortie. Can I have the
Sortie.
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 Mm-hmm.
It's one mission or attack by a single plane.
Sortie. S-O-R-T-I-E. Sortie.
That's right. Your word is forsythia.
Forsythia. May I have a definition, please?
Any plant of a small genus of ornamental shrubs with opposite leaves and bright yellow bell-shaped flowers, which appear before the leaves in early spring.
Forsythia. F-O-R-S-Y-T-H-I-A. Forsythia.
Right. This word has a homonym. It's all. It's from the Kazan Tartar and words that passed through Russian before becoming English. It's a noun. It's a mountain or desert settlement as a village in the Caucasus region. All.
All. A-U-L. All.
Yes. This word is a near homonym, camphor. Word is from a word that went from Malay to Arabic to Latin to Anglo-French, then English. It's a noun. It's a tough, gum-like substance obtained especially from the wood and bark of the camphor tree and is used as a stimulant in medicine or as an insect repellent. Camphor.
Would you repeat the word, please?
Camphor.
Camphor. May I have the language of origin?
Okay, it's from Malay to Arabic to Latin to Anglo-French and then English.
Camphor. C-A-M-F-I-R, camphor.
Sorry. End of round nine. All right, we'll start our next round. Your word is Panglossian.
Panglossian. Can I have the definition?
You may. Marked by the view that all is for the best in this best of possible worlds.
Can I have it in a sentence?
Mm-hmm. Voltaire mocked the philosophy of Leibniz as a Panglossian absurdity.
Panglossian. P-A-N-G-L-O-S-S-I-A-N. Panglossian.
Correct. Your word is macrame.
Macrame. M-A-C-R-A-M-E. Macrame.
Yes. Your word, ostentatious.
Ostentatious. May I have a definition, please?
You may. Attracting or seeking to attract attention, often by gaudiness or obviousness. Conspicuous.
Ostentatious. O-S-T-E-N-T-A-T-I-O-U-S. Ostentatious.
Correct. Your word is poltergeist.
Poltergeist. May I please have the definition?
A noisy and usually mischievous ghost.
Poltergeist. P-O-L. P-E-R-G-E-I-S-T, poltergeist.
Right. End of round 10. All right. Your word is mediocre.
Mediocre. M-E-D. I-O-C-R-E, mediocre.
That's right. Nothing mediocre about that. You're right. Your word is dressage.
Dressage. Can I get the definition?
Mm-hmm. The execution by a horse of maneuvers involving changes of gait, pace, and airs in response to barely perceptible movements of a rider's hands, legs, and weight.
Dressage. D-R-E-S-S-A-G-E, dressage.
Right. This could be confused with another word. It's Cossack. It's from a Turkish-derived Russian word and a Turkish-derived Ukrainian word. It's a noun. It's a member of a favored military cast of Russian frontiersmen and border guards in Tsarist Russia who played an important part in Russian expansion. Cossack.
Cossack. C-O-S-S-A-C-K. Cossack.
Right. Your word is erudite.
Erudite. May you please have the definition?
Characterized by a love of knowledge for its own sake, devoted to the pursuit of learning.
Erudite. E-R-U-D-I-T-E. Erudite.
Right. End of round 11. All right, let's continue now. This word could be confused with another word. It's opossum. It's from Algonquin origin. It's a noun. It's an omnivorous, largely nocturnal, and arboreal animal, that has a prehensile tail and an abdominal pouch to which the young are transferred at birth, and that reputedly feigns death when startled or alarmed. Opossum.
Opossum. O-P-P-O-S-S-U-M, opossum.
Sorry. Your word is troika.
Troika. T-R-O-I-K-A, troika.
Yes. We're down to a troika, as you can see. Three. Your word is eiderdown.
Eiderdown. May I have a definition, please?
The small, fluffy underfeathers of any several large northern sea ducks.
May I have the language of origin?
It is from an old Norse word that went into Icelandic, then German, then English.
Eiderdown. E-I-D-E-R-D-O-W-N. Eiderdown.
Yes. Your word is geranium.
Geranium. Will you please have that definition?
Any of a widely distributed genus of plants having regular flowers without spurs and with glands that alternate with the petals.
Geranium. G-E-R-A-N-I-U-M. Geranium.
Correct. Okay, end of round 12. Continue with the three of you now. Next word is parapet.
Parapet. P-A-R-A-P-E-T. Parapet.
That's right. Your word is tsunami.
Tsunami. May I have a definition, please?
Mm-hmm. A great sea wave produced by submarine earth movement. Or volcanic eruption, a tidal wave.
Tsunami. T-S-U-N-A-M-I. Tsunami.
Correct. Your word is azimuth.
Azimuth. May you please have the definition?
An arc of the horizon measured between a fixed point, as true north, and the vertical circle passing through the center of an object.
Azimuth. A-Z-I-M-U-T-H. Azimuth.
Correct. End of 13. Your word is springbok.
Springbok. S-P-R-I-N-G-B-O-K. Springbok.
That's right. Your word is backstein.
Backstein. May I have a definition, please?
A German cheese resembling Limburger that's produced in brick shape.
Backstein. B-A-C-K-S-T-E-I-N. Backstein.
That's right. This next word could be confused with another word. It's femininity. originally Latin. This word went through French before becoming English. It's a noun. It's the quality or nature of the female gender, womanliness, femininity.
Femininity. F-E-M-I-N-I-N-I-T-Y, femininity.
That's right. End of round 14. This word could be confused with another word. It's picaresque. It's from the Spanish. It's an adjective. It's relating to or being a type of prose fiction in which a rogue or vagabond is engaged in a chronological series of episodes with little or no complication of plot.
Picaresque. P-I-C-A-R-E-S-Q-U-E. Picaresque.
Right. Your word is herpetology.
Herpetology. H-E-R-P-E-T-O-L-O-G-Y. Herpetology.
Very good. The word is verboten.
Verboten. May I please have the definition?
Forbidden, especially by dictate, prohibited.
Verboten. V-E-R-B-O. T-E-N, verboten.
That's correct. End of 15th round. Very good. Your word is quinine.
Quinine. Q-U-I-N-I-N-E, quinine.
Very good. The word is nabob.
Nabob. N-A-B-O-B. Nabob.
Right. Your word is heifer.
Heifer. May I please have the definition?
A young cow.
Heifer. H-E-I-F-E-R. Heifer.
Right. End of the 16th round. Hope you brought your lunch, folks. Your word is knocked music.
Knocked music.
Yeah.
Can I get the definition?
Mm-hmm. Music sung or played, especially in the open air, in compliment to a person or group.
Knocked music. N-A-C-H-T-M-U-S-I-K, knocked music.
Yeah, that's right. Your word is lieutenant.
Lieutenant. May I have a definition, please?
A commissioned officer in the Army, Navy, Air Force, or Marine Corps.
Lieutenant. L-I-E-U-T-E-N-A-N-T, lieutenant.
Very good. The word is prerogative.
Prerogative. May you please have the definition?
A special right or privilege belonging to a person, group, or class of individuals.
Prerogative. P-R-E-R-O-G-G-A-T-I-V-E. Prerogative.
Sorry. All right. End of round 17. Now the rules change a little bit. As you can see, we're down to two contestants. So the idea is, I'll ask a word, someone spells the word, we go to the next person. But if somebody misspells the word, the next person in line has to spell that same word correctly and one more word correctly. Otherwise, we go back round and round. Deep breath, guys. Stand up. Stretch. Touch your toes.
I can't do that.
Okay. I can't do it either, so that's all right. All right. We'll start our next round. Good luck. The word has a near homonym. It's Eiselberg, and it's originally from the German, it's a noun. It's an isolated mountain, partly buried by the debris derived from and overlapping its slopes. Eiselberg.
Eiselberg.
Let me say that again. Inselberg, correct? Inselberg.
I-N-S-E-L-B-E-R-G.
That's correct. Thank you, judges. I don't use that word every day. Your word is borzoi.
Borzoi. B-O-R-Z-O-I. Borzoi.
Right. It's the end of the 18th. Back up again. Your word is cordovan.
Can I get the definition?
Mm-hmm. A variable color averaging a dark grayish red.
Cordovan. C-O-R-D-O-V-A-N. Cordovan.
Yes. Your word is guillotine.
Guillotine. G-U-I-L-L-O-T-I-N-E. Guillotine.
That's right. And the 19th round. Okay, this word has a homonym, comma. It's from the Sanskrit. It's a noun. It's the enjoyment of the world of the senses, constituting one of the goals of humans in Hinduism, comma.
Can you say it again?
Comma.
Common?
Comma.
Comma. K-A-M-A, comma.
That's right. Your word is samovar.
Samovar. S-A-M-O-V-A-R, samovar.
Right. Wow. End of the 20th. Your word is kohlrabi.
Kohlrabi. K-O-H-L-R-A-B-I. Kohlrabi.
That's right. Your word is diphthong.
Diphthong. May I have a definition, please?
Mm-hmm. A gliding monosyllabic sound that starts at or near the articulary position of one vowel and moves to or toward the position of another. Articulatory position.
May I have the language of origin?
It's from the Greek, diphthong.
Diphthong. D-I-P-T-H-O-N-G, diphthong.
Sorry. Same word will go to you.
Diphthong.
Diphthong.
D-I-P-H-T-H-O-N-G, diphthong.
And one more word. Karuma.
Karuma. K-U-R-U-M-A. Karuma.
Congratulations.